Like, there's no way for you to escape anything there. And it's not like there's insane amount of appeal from Copenhagen Wolves. It's more them wanting to engage.
Well, there's the team comps on your screen. Hit us up on Twitter, guys, at LOL Esports, hashtag GIAWin, or hashtag CW.
Now Pepinero joining in the Notice Award, and Youngbuck, oh, he might be a dead Yordle.
Let's see Frederick and Pepinero coming in. Youngbuck, he knew they were around. This is going to be a dead Youngbuck. First blood will be secured by Giants.
So you get ganked, you flash, and you tanky. Jack's a little bit different to deal with. Let's see, Teleport in the bottom lane.
He's come down. Let's see if Whirlip can help out. Unlimited and Freeze are going aggressive. It's now 2-on-1. Exhaust comes down. That's a double Counter-Strike.
He's all alone, though.
Still 2-on-1. If a stun connects, Whirlip's in trouble. He gets caught up by concussive blows. Rydell comes in with 100 HP. He manages to play in. He's gone in with a death sentence. Why did you do that? Audrey gets baited and forced to flash. And Copenhagen will teleporting to a very low duo. I mean, I anticipate he was teleporting during a fight, so can't say too much. Oh, Airwax is in trouble. Pepe's gonna spur rush over. That's a dead pony. Airwax trying to counter jungle and just gives up a kill to the Giants.
Some sloppy stuff.
We'll see how quickly he can get his hands on that item. That's a level 6 freeze. Rydell is in trouble. One more hit will stun him. Concussive blows hold him in place. Look at those Ren stacks. Not enough for the kill yet, but we do see the Fate's Call to...
He's got a little nice poke from Kreppo actually backstage, and he has a very valid point. The Rent from Freeze will be the slow in here, but let's get that after Youngbuck is dead.
All right, let's go back to story time from Kreppo. Oh, yeah. Flash! So, Frederick, whoa, that was close. That was so, so close, but Frederick gets out alive. Copenhagen Wolves, double smites, gonna start themselves off on a dragon. Nobody from Giants will reply, so this should be the first objective.
So the combo here between them,
Graves.
Because Freeze has to slow himself
no collateral
from
damage.
His E there, you don't actually need the chilling smite, but dragon going over to the Copenhagen Wolves again.
Moves, forcing Copenhagen Wolves to react. Youngbuck gets jumped on, Counter-Strike running, Werlib has got damage down, double Doran's is burning through, Youngbuck forced to flash, Werlib is thinking about it.
That's
he flashes, he leaps, he scores!
Just like yesterday.
Werlib gets the kill, Youngbuck, it's the feed to win strategy.
Lane. Getting a kill here and there.
Oh, Frederick is about to find Airwax. He's got Assault and Battery available. He's charging. He goes in. Airwax, you're going to get caught. Frederick with the timing. Oh, that was brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Battery's up. What resources are going to use to kill Zerath?
Okay, maybe not.
That's a dead Zerath. Absolutely destroyed. And Giants are going to secure.
Off as well. Over to Giants. Trying to disengage here. Let's see. Airwax going in and
Tom,
dying.
Death sentence dead. That's it.
And the crowd is not.
Giants should get themselves an uncontested.
Again,
dragon.
He's just so far behind. You want to get the warrior enchant on Hecarim and then just go full tank from there. You can't really go Trinity Force in the jungle unless you get so far ahead in the early game, which of course.
Much from Jax. He's got that Trinity Force completed and Copenhagen.
A lot of people top lane
though. Going to try and gank him. Willip gets knocked backwards. He's going to get that armor and MR. And truthfully, this is going to be a dead top laner or not.
Whoa, is
he
it?
Leaps to a ward.
Pepinero rifle here.
Now the Giants are going to turn it back around. Unlimited has going to be able to
Freeze
throw that
in.
Ultimate down. Let's see what can happen. We do see Braum going forward. That's the Glacial Fisher down on the ground. Fire's going to re-engage. Youngbuck is in trouble. Nah, throws everybody backwards. Rydell, flash, flay, death sentence, and they kill Youngbuck. Everybody involved, but only the single.
As Pepinero came in, Freeze actually had to save Unlimited, pull him in the ulti here, tried to re-engage. Pepinero catching Freeze.
Oh, let's see what they can make of this. Frederick has still got his Assault and Battery available and limited the next target. We do see the spell coming down from Sorin, but it's just not enough damage. Giants are going to be able.
The Baron, you have also the Rent damage from Freeze. Remember, he can stack up to an insane amount of damage from him. And again, Airwax and Unlimited should be able to time the two smites together, but Whirlip is here.
Well, let's see what Whirlip can do. There's members of Copenhagen Wolves all going low.
Baron
has been secured by the Copenhagen Wolves. But what damage can Whirlip do?
They lost
that's
it.
Two, that's three. Whirlip's going to get out alive.
No,
he's shut down. Triple kill picked up. Sorin forced to flash, but he's got no mana remaining. Frederick should be able to run him down with that Assault and Battery. Three members of the Wolves have lost that Baron buff. Only Youngbuck has escaped, and I don't think Sorin's going to be able to get away. He does have an empowered recall. If he can find a few seconds of peace, maybe, but I might just be too optimistic. Rydell's running
it's
him
gonna
down.
It's going to be a one-on-one here
with
between
those
Sorin and Rydell.
Rydell's going to get stunned. Let's see. Empowered recall? No.
Nope, just died to the tower here.
Do the recall. Oh, going to take damage.
Kind of
won't be able to. Won't be able to. So
and
Sorin, then a suicide. So only Youngbuck gets Giants control. There is simply nothing the Wolves can do at this point in time. Frederick, he's going all the way in. Soren's in trouble. Collateral damage comes down from the sidelines. First victim of the fight. Who will it be? Right to the Arcane gets channeled. One,
that
two,
one.
Third one does secure. We do see Freeze picking up a kill as well. That Bloodthirster and Ren stacks is going to be enough.
Right now, so just get this dragon, wait for the Baron to spawn, pick it up, or at least force the Wolves into a fight around it. And then just do like a 1-3-1 split push. Have Atreus sitting. Wolves are not in a position to fight just yet. This one goes down fast.
So we'll see if they can secure it. All three shots of Passage of the Arcane comes out. Glacial Fissure goes down. Baron secured. It doesn't work. Just in absolute control. With Baron buff and one dragon away from that mega buff, there's very little at the could work for them. Instead, they're going to try brute force their way in. Frederick has gone deep.
He's going
found
straight
his
for
way
to
Soren. We do see Airwax throwing himself into the team, but that's Soren and Freeze down.
Well, that
there's
works
no
too.
Damage left for the Copenhagen Wolves. Youngbuck forced into retreat. He throws down the Gnar in reverse, but it doesn't matter. Wurlib grabs himself the triple kill, closed out by Pepe, despite the fact that Wurlib is shut down. Giants are going to get the inhibitor. They're going to get an exposed amount of time on the Nexus, and this should be their game. 2-0 in week one.
And Giants realizing, yeah, we don't really want to siege this tower and just slowly take it down. Let's just dive. We are so far ahead. Instant lockdown, Soren killed him. Finish up everything. Wurlib on this Jax. Second game now where he gets a great start and he just completely snowballed the game.
Well, Giants opening week in the LCS is flawless. 2-0. Both one-sided victories.
Yeah. Very
you
one-sided.
Know what? If Giants are going to be proving themselves, they've done it. You start your way with the teams who have been down at the bottom half of the LCS tables. MYM, the old Super Hot Crew, Copenhagen Wolves, both teams that have flirted with promotion tournaments in the lower echelons of 2014. Giants have bested them both, and fairly convincingly. It's a good start to their 2015.
Yeah, especially because they came in as just the second expansion tournament team. Obviously H2K won the expansion tournament 3-0 against Giants Gaming, and now coming here getting a great start. Copenhagen Wolves on NYM being defeated. We'll have to see if they can keep it up for next week. I have a feeling that teams, or I really hope the teams realize now, when Jax is being logged in, Frederick is going to go top lane. Pepe Nero is going to go top lane. Don't let him get those easy kills so he starts getting ahead, because then the rest of the team will just use it to completely take over the map and just constantly fight you.
Yeah, Giants really show that they've got vision control, they've got the decision making, they play the map, they play the objectives. It's a little slow, but you know, it doesn't matter because it's their pace, it's their tempo, and they're in the lead. Now, these are against opponents who, again, are slightly lower down. We need to see how they perform against the slightly stronger teams, against the Fnatics, against
SK Gaming.